Hello friends, in this video we are about to see Max ERP software demo for textile and apparel retail outlets. So we'll just start with the login. There are a lot of configurations and features involved in Max ERP related to textile and apparel retail stores. To start, we'll just start with creation of a couple of customers. Customers can be created in the masters, or they can even be created directly while billing in a POS screen along with name and mobile number. So I'll just save it quickly. Only the customer name and the state is mandatory. Rest of the information can be blank. It's all optional. But the more detailed you fill in the master, the more combination of reports you'll be able to generate. So I'm just saving one of the customer quickly. Same way, we'll just go and create one of the supplier. Let's say I'll just create saying supplier saying PTEX sarees, and I can mention a state saying Tamil Nadu. Along with that, you can mention the key contact person details, the taxation information, the default trade days limit provided by the vendor. Even this is applicable for customers also if you go to customer master. Along with vendor, you can define the default markup that you want to keep on the products which are purchased from this particular vendor. So if you define it here, while purchase entry, this will automatically come in. Let's say we define a 40% markup and save this. I will create one more supplier saying, let's say, Prime. So I just created two suppliers. We can even maintain complete financial accounting into this. So our bank account, cash accounts, your expenses, salary account. Let's say I just create a bank account. Okay, it's already there, HDFC Bank, which is grouped under this bank account. I can create another account saying, let's say, Kotak. Likewise, I can create another expense account like office expenses already there. You can create your capital accounts, partners capital account. Only thing you have to make sure is you group them under the correct accounting group. If it's partners capital account, you just have to select partners capital, loans, advances. So based on this, you get complete financial accounting till the final accounts. Next, we'll just create a few products. We can even create our salesperson in between. In case if you want to provide some incentives to your salesperson, you can create multiple salespeople here. And let's say I just create SP1, SP2. I just created two salesperson, and let's say we create a couple of products now. Okay, we already have few products here. The main thing in Product Master is to define the correct product type for the product. See, where you are able to see multiple product types on the screen. We have something called auto tracking unique, auto tracking set. What does this mean is, auto tracking unique means each and every piece will have a unique barcode number. Even if you have same color shirt, same size four pieces, still each of this piece will have a unique number. Same way when you have auto tracking set, and when you're purchasing a particular same size, same color shirt, four pieces, all those four will have one barcode, similar barcode. So one barcode number will have four quantity. In this case, each barcode number will have one piece, one quantity only. Then manual tracking can be used for using the supplier barcode number itself. Manual tracking for those kind of products. Material is for your roll based dress material, which comes in 80 meters, 100 meter roll, and which you cut and sell to the customer. So we'll see an example of all of this. And so I'll just show you, let's say we create a men's shirt. I create auto tracking set. Grouping, let's say new shirts, menswear. Brand name is not required here because we might have different brands coming with men's shirt product. So here we have a matrix option where if this product has any matrix linked, size, color kind of thing. So we have a predefined matrix here which has five size, color, brand, style, season, design. Six columns are configured. You can configure up to 10 columns. But in case if you do not want all these columns to be configured, we can even change that in the matrix master configuration details. So right now, let's say I just select matrix name, size, color, and we'll move ahead. it comes in pieces. So you even have a minimum markup on this product, which can be defined in the product master itself. And based on this, it will automatically apply while you take the purchase. So minimum and maximum markup can be defined here. Let's say the HSN code for this product is SK123. Now we have an option for multiple GST here. So ready-mades, in case by default it is 5%, and above 1000 rupees, it's 12%. So you can segregate or have multiple GSTs as per the value of the product. Okay. We are not defining any other details here because it will keep varying from different, your landing cost will keep changing from men's shirts as per the different variety and styles. You can predefine your matrix details here. So men's wear, what all sizes do you deal in? So you can select the predefined sizes here. Same way you can even predefine some colors, or you can define new colors and choose them. So if you want, if you do not define this here, you can even do it while purchase entry. We have one option here saying rate jump. So this is also a useful option where if you want to distinct size wise incremental rates, so you can have a rate jump of 20 rupees across each size. So you can just save this. We already have one product called designer sari with no matrix, and it is auto tracking unique. The current shirt product that we have created, men's shirt, is auto tracking set. We'll just create another product saying it's a dress material, and we'll just give them, let us say, product type material. No category, no matrix. A matrix, if you want, you can define the size, or if you can define the color if required, along with the design number of the supplier. We can create even multiple matrix here. Let's say we just create another matrix saying just a design. And that's right here. So usually in this dust material product, you might require only a design column. It comes in meters, and HSN code you can define here, let's say 5% tax, and save this. We'll just edit the same product again with a, so dust material, I just select a matrix saying design only. I do not want all these parameters. So this is how we have created all the three products are there. Now we have designer sarees with auto tracking unique, and we have our men's wear ready-made shirts with auto tracking set, and dress material product with product type material. Now let's see their application and the billing. And before this, if you want to configure your modes of payment, you can even configure your mode of payment for the, so you have HDFC bank card configured. If you even want Kotak bank to be configured as one of your card types, you can define the Kotak bank account and save it here. Okay, now after the master creation, we'll directly jump into the purchase. We have the complete flow right from purchase order generation to GRN good receipts node, or if you have purchased something on approval basis or consignment basis, even those could be entered here. And along with purchase, we even have a bulk purchase return also, wherein all the goods which are to be returned to different vendors, if they are all held up or at one place, from there you can quickly scan in a single screen, and once you save that voucher, the purchase return for respective product as per the vendors, it will get grouped, and all automatically individual purchase return vouchers will get generated. But right now in this demo, we'll just see a quick purchase entry here. Let's say supply bill number 123, your date of entry, the actual invoice date, whether it's a cash purchase or a credit purchase. Supplies invoice amount, let's say 10,000 P, and we are buying from PTEX Saris. And from PTEX, I just take, let's say, designer sari. So once I select designer sari, it is not asking me any other information. There's no matrix details here, it's just asking me the sales right now. There is a chances where even with sari, we might have to record the supplier's design number. So I'll just change the matrix detail for the sari here. The matrix details cannot be altered once the product are used, so you have to define it correctly in the master level. So I'll just mention a design number here. So we will have to track the supplier's design code also. So I'm just selecting it again, and you can see the design column coming here. So let's say we purchase 10 saris, out of which 4 saris are costing us 500 rupees each with no discount on it. Cost rate, your 40% default markup of the PTEX have automatically come here. If you directly want to alter a sales rate also, you can define a sales rate, or you can even change your margins. We have markup, we have a direct sales rate option also, and this is the actual profit margin. So we can even change the profit margin. If you want 50% profit margin, then it will be 1000 rupees automatically. So all the three way, 100% markup is 50% margin. The suppliers design code, let's say 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 1, and the balance 6 sarees with the same rate, and let's say design number is 2222. And this rate has come here, and we just save this. You have discount option to be configured on individual product as well as on the entire bill. Also, I can mention a 600 rupees discount, or you can just mention a percentage here. So we'll just save this. So it says supplier invoice amount did not match. So even there's a single quantity or rate mismatch, then this supplier's invoice amount, which we have mentioned in the beginning, will not match with our purchase bill total. That way we'll have 100% accuracy in purchase. So let's say I just change this temporarily for this purchase demo purposes. And once we save this, since it was auto tracking unique, you find 10 unique barcode numbers that have got generated. So it is RS00001. We can even configure the prefix and the suffix with each of the barcode numbers that you want. And we even have the encrypted sales rate, encrypted cost rate coming with each of the product. So this code also can be predefined and can be printed on barcode sticker along with the supplier bill number details and the supplier code if you have. Now with each of this barcode, you can attach an image along with it by just selecting an attach image. You can either get from webcam, or you can scan from a scanner, or you can directly browse and select an image from your. You just select one screenshot just like that. Just save this. So with this product, we have linked one image with RS001. You can print your barcode labels in an A4 sheet also with from a laser printer, or you can even use a barcode printer, dedicated barcode printer with two stickers or four stickers, however is it, that we can configure in this. So barcode sticker contents are also configurable, and you can use a laser printer or a barcode printer also for printing your barcode stickers. So after the barcode printing, let's say we take one more purchase from another vendor. Let's say we take Prime. So last 12 months performance graph of Prime is shown below. And if you have any purchase agent in between, you can even select an agent here. So accordingly, agent wise outstanding can also be tracked. We'll just select the second product here, saying dress material and let's say men's shirt. So in men's shirt, we had a rate jumping option. So it is automatically asking us, let's say we have purchased 15 men's shirt starting from L to double XL, rate of 450 each and a markup of 40%, or let's say we just define a selling rate of 750 with a rate difference of 20 incremental from first. Once we click and load this, automatically 15 pieces have been split among 555 each with small, large XL and double XL sizes. And if you could see, the sales rate has been 750, 770 and 790. Here you can quickly select the color for all these shirts. Select color and brand and style. If you do not have anything, you can just mention a dot, or you can even type a new value here. If you have a new brand, then you can just type a new brand and get it created immediately. And season, let's say a casual wear, and design number. And we can save this. We'll even take a dress material from the same vendor. So once we select dress material, you will see some other additional information on the screen. Let's say we're buying 400 meters of dress material. So it's asking us the length and the rolls. Let's say we have 80 meter length into 2, and let's say 300 rupees per meter, and our selling rate is, let's say, 400 rupees. So 80, 80, 160 is already allocated from 400. Let's say we have another 100 into 2. So 360 from 400 has been allocated, and remaining 40, let's say we have one single row. So this way, 400 meters have been split among 5 different rolls. So you get unique 5 unique stickers, and you need to mention the design number. So let's say design number is 9999. 8888, and supplier wise, product wise, previous supply date, rate history will also be displayed once you come on the rate column. So here we will just save it. So the bill value is 133,000. You can even mention additional cost for the product. So if you have any other unloading charges or other transport charges, you can add that and add to the costing of the products by using it. This will not have any impact on the accounts, just your landing cost of the product will increase. So let's just save this purchase. And once we save this, you will find men's shirt, there are only two or three stickers, five each. Each of them is having five quantity. Since it was auto tracking set, the same design pattern is getting created with same set of codes. So this barcode number 11 will have 5 pieces, 12 will have 5 pieces. Same way dress material is also having, we had 5 different rolls, so you can just change the number of sticker copies that are required. And for 5 rolls with different quantity, you are able to see now. Each roll you have the length also coming in. 80, 80, 100, 100, 100 along with the design numbers. So 5 stickers for the dress material rolls will also get generated. After the purchase, we can just see, go to inventory and see our stock summary report and just click show. So this will just show us the total stock of dress material, the designer sari that we have along with the costing of the product. So and the total stock value will also be shown here. And we have men's shirt. You can even see a detailed stock summary report with a clear distinction on opening, inward, output and closing for a date range. If you just want to track this week's performance, you can just click this week and it will show you in opening of the week for each of the product, total inward, total outward and closing. At any point of time, you can just double click to the details and you can jump to the transaction level. So when all inward output has happened, and you can just quickly come to the transaction. Now we'll just look into the sales part of it. After purchase, we'll directly start with the sales, where we have options for order, consignment sales or approval sales is also there, along with invoice and return options. We'll start with the sales order. So let's say we take an order from, we can even create a new customer from here. So let's say we'll select an existing customer from it and take an order for, let's say designer sari, 2 pieces and let's say 5,000 or 10,000 per piece. And we can even mention the advance amount in the sales order. Let's say the customers paid 10,000 piece advance. And we can save it quickly. Before saving, if you want some remarks to be configured against each product, you can even configure the remarks options against each product. As well as you can mention the due date for the customer, let's say 30th January is the delivery date for this order. And you can save this. You can accept partial cash and partial card also, again for the advance amount of 10,000. And once you have saved this, the order is generated. You can always go to the pending order report under the sales menu and you can see product wise what all orders are pending. So for Sumit, there's one order pending for designer sari. 2 pieces are left, are the pending order. We have 10 in stock and you can even cancel the particular order, or you can even convert a partial order out of 2. Only 1 can be supplied and 1 can be cancelled. All that options are available. Advance amount against the order is also being displayed. The delivery due date is also being shown here. Now along with this, now if you want to convert the sales order to an invoice, as you can double click the particular order and just click make invoice here, or you can directly go to a sales invoice menu or a retail POS menu. Under POS, you can just select the customer name saying Sumit, and automatically its pending orders will be shown. So let's say we select both the pieces and it is asking us which particular barcodes are being sent. So we have selected 2 and 4 number. So 10,000, as per the order rate, the values have changed. Irrespective of our cost for the sari, whatever is the order value, that those rates will get updated here. You can even update the customer mobile number here. And let's say we just save this. So once we save, it is asking us, it is showing one credit note bar advance option. So here we can just select the existing advance amount of 10,000 and the balance 10,000, let's say we are collecting in Kotak and just saving it. So once you save, it will show you, we can configure this print format in A4 half size or entire A4 size paper or a thermal 4 inches, 3 inches printer. So it will show you the complete information on which barcode numbers are being built, what is the value, what is the tax, and the software automatically takes care of the tax inclusion in the MRP rate itself. And the payment summary is also being shown. Likewise, if we just generate a direct sales bill of let's say the first product. So if there's an image linked, it will show you the image first to verify the product, and you can directly save this transaction also. Let's say 1,000 rupees cash. For a dress material product, let's say we just verify the barcode numbers. So we have a special batch movement report in which we can verify all the stocks available with us. So now it is showing us designer sari out of 10 pieces, 3 has been sold, 7 are left. So we'll just take dress material barcode number is RS00014. So when we select RS00014, it will ask us the length and the number of pieces that is required by the client. So if a customer says they need 4 meters into 3 pieces, 3 pieces of 4 meter length each, then automatically from this particular roll, a 12 meter of stock has got reduced with 400 rupees as the selling rate. Let's say we take a men's shirt, RS00001. Okay, if we just select one more, since it's an auto tracking set, it will add to the same quantity. If I just select once more, the quantity has got changed to 3. And we even have a return option directly in the POS where you can just select return, and if any of the earlier barcode is being written back, it has. So that product will get detected automatically, and that will, this product, return product, will get added back to the stock, and the difference value is only being billed to the customer. So once you save this, you can just create a new customer directly. Let's say enter mobile number. Let's say, and you save this. So let's say customer tender is 8,000, so balance refund amount will also be shown. Now with an exchange kind of concept, you will have a clarity in the billing where these two barcodes are being sold and this particular one is being written, and the difference amount only is being billed to the customer. So this is how we do a retail sales, where just we can scan and select quickly. Now we'll see an example of a consignment sales also. So you go to sales menu and let's say we just select. For consignment sales, it's delivery note bar approval. So we can just select a barcode number. Product is asking me length, let's say 10 meters, 2 pieces. So consignment sales will not get saved when the customer name is compulsory. So let's say we select customer name saying alright, and we just save this. So delivery challan or consignment sales can get generated with all the information of the product in the same. You can always track all the pending sale challan, things which you have given on consignment basis. You can always verify where there are 3 products. Likewise, if there are multiple customers, customer wise all the products will be displayed on your screen, and you can quickly track them or convert them to an invoice also. So if you want to just convert it to an invoice, you can click make invoice here, or alternatively you can just go to POS screen again and just select the customer name. Okay. And all the 3 products which have been billed to the customer, if you are converting all those 3 into invoices, you can select or you can partially convert also. Let's say you just select this 20 meters and save this. And again you come back to your challan. See, the stock has already got affected at the consignment level itself. We even have a consignment return option. Let's say if the customer is just selecting this dress material and returning one of the designer sari back, you can go to option other vouchers and deliver return challan. You can just type the customer name you are saying Abhay. Once you select a customer name, there are only 2 products left with him. So what is he returning? Let's say he's returning this designer sari. And you just save this. Now when you check your pending challan report, it will just show you that Abhay, there's only 1 product left. the other one has come as return. So now when you prepare the next bill, the return one is already in the stock. There's only one which is left pending with the customer. You can even verify the stock report against the same. You can just go to inventory and see your stock summary. So now the dust material left with us is 368 and designer saree is 8 pieces, men's wear is 11 pieces left. You can see the detailed stock summary again to have better clarity. So out of 15, 11 pieces are only left, 4 has went out. To whom all it has went out, so you can just double click and see a transaction. From Prime it was in good of 15, 3 has been sold to Priya and 1 has been sold to Abhay. And it's sale challan, which means it's still on consignment. So this is how we enter a consignment or an approval challan along with approval returns and convert them to POS billing. A lot of reporting options available after based on the sales. So you can just go to sales register and just click show and you can just verify the total sales of the day. It will show you the summary of the total cash, advance adjusted, card and bank wise. A lot of options available here where you can just see tender summary wise sales and you can track bill wise what all tender, mode of tender has been used, payment, and you can even track your product group by sales here. You can just see the total supplier by sales. So PTEX we have only sold two sarees from Prime we have sold. So turnover for PTEX and turnover for Prime. We have special report to analyze vendor wise performance, vendor city wise performance also. But right now with this demo we'll just continue here. All these reports can be emailed directly by just clicking print and you can even export it to Excel or any format, PDF format that you want. There are multiple options for us to explore in the sales register. Post this, we'll just see the inventory batch movement report again. You can always track your stock aging and products which are older than 60 days or 90 days, you can generate bulk discount for them. We have an option here where you can just provide bulk discount for clearance sales for products which are aging or which are specific to one particular design, color, brand. You can filter in that combination. So this batch movement report is a special report which will show you the profits also. So let's say we just see all stocks and once we click show it says designer saree. You can always summarize these options. It will show designer saree out of 10, 2 has been sold, 8 is left. You can go to options and if you want you can just click show profits. You can filter any particular design number or particular size and you can just click apply. So now it is showing us profits made with each of the product, the gross profit. So total profit made on designer saree is 18,000 and total on dress material as well as on men's shirt. As per the sales made, it is just showing you the profits. You can always filter all these reports from the, if you just want to filter a particular design number, you can just select and you can track profits here. Same way, if you want a particular size, you can just mention Excel or double Excel and the product will be shown. You can even filter this by going to the options menu. Now we can just track this particular product. There was an inward and outward, there's no closing stock left. If you want to track to whom this product has been sent to, you can just open this plus sign and you can always see the purchase and the sales. You can double click here to open the purchase transaction. You can just double click here to even check the sales. This is one single report which will give you all the combinations of sales or purchase, product wise, vendor wise. Let's say you can even just scan a barcode saying, if you just scan one barcode, you can track the complete history of the barcode, the number of days it is old, from which vendor it has come to. All the details can be tracked from one single report. You can track your day-wise profits, product-wise profits, supplier-wise profits, profit in any combination, particular design-wise profit, piece-wise profit, all these combinations can be found out with this one single report. You can even track your profits in the sales register by just going to options and you can just click show profits here. So once you click here, it is showing you profit for each individual bill. So bill-wise profits are being displayed here and the overall profit that is made. You can always filter all your reports with for this week or this month and track your profits for the week, for the day, or for the month or till date, and that's the supports will get loaded that way. Now let us see an example of a purchase return voucher also. So we'll just go to the batch movement report again, or we can go to stock summary also, where we can see batch wise stock and click show. So we'll just see the products that are left with us. So designer saree RS003. So you can just go to purchase return voucher and just scan the barcode. So it will automatically select the vendor, PTEC saree, and the bill reference details will also come automatically. PTEC, let's say these two products are being written back. So once you save this, it will ask you whether you want to adjust this amount against any existing bill. If you just select this, it will show you the bill that is left with PTEC. That's one purchase for 5600 in which this amount is getting adjusted. So there's a purchase return voucher which is generated. While in the print of the purchase return voucher, it will even show you complete details of the supplier design number, the barcode number which we have generated against the reference bill number and the dated bill date. So information will be here which can directly be emailed from here. So let's see the accounting part from here. So you can just see your bills receivable, and it will show you all the bills which are pending from customers. So if you have sold anything on credit, even the credit bills can be shown here. So for credit bills, you can use the sales invoice mode, as well as for retail sales, you can use the POS mode. Under POS also, we can configure credit if required. Same way, under accounts, if we go for the bills payable, then this is showing us PTEC, there's one bill due. Amount was 5600, out of which only 4480 is pending. You can just see the adjustments by clicking the plus sign here. So there's a purchase return which has been adjusted against this bill. Similarly, Prime, there's one bill for 133,000 which is not yet paid. You can even go to the accounting ledger menu and track the ledger of every customer also. If you just select Sumit, that is showing you there's one order and then there's one bill in which the payment has been made, there's no outstanding left. When you select PTEC here, it will show you there's a purchase bill for 5600 and then a return for 1120. So for the accounting part, let's say we just make a payment. Let's say make a cash payment to PTEC service. So once we select PTEC, the existing outstanding is being listed here. Let's say we made a payment of 4000 rupees. So this 4000 is adjusted against which bill is being shown here. So we can adjust this 4000 against the first bill itself by pressing an enter. If you want the balance amount to be rounded off, let's say you want to discount the balance amount of 480 rupees, then you can just select this, type in the discount here, and the account will get completely settled. So once you save this, you can even print the payment voucher. It will show you clear information on the payment voucher, the check number and the bank details. So it shows the bill 5600 against which 1120 is written, and due amount and the account which has been settled by making payment of 4000 rupees. Now you see the ledger of PTEC again. So it says there's a payment of 4000 and then a trade discount of 480, the account balance is nil. Even in bills payable, once you click show, the PTEC will get cleared. We have complete accounts till GST returns. Everything can be easily managed in this, and you can even verify your final accounts with balance sheet and other options. There are a lot of other modules in this where you can just go for a clearance sale setup, where you can either select stock which are aging more than 10 days or 100 days. Those will get listed. So right now, let's say zero. So you can filter all the products which are available here, and you can apply bulk discounts on those. You can filter the products which are older than 180 days and select bulk update, and you can just mention a discount rate of 5% or 10% accordingly. You can filter a particular brand and on those brand only if you want, or on those specific color itself. Any specific matrix details can be filtered, and on that discount can be applied in bulk. Once you apply the discount and you click update here, this products will have the new discounts being applied while the billing. So you automatically get 5% discount. This is just one for clearance sale setup, where you can set up racks for 5% discount, 10% discount, 20% discount likewise, and quickly apply discount on those non-moving products. Apart from this, we have lot of features in the application wherein you can compare multiple matrix wise, size, color wise combination of reports, compare which product is moving fast, which is moving slow. You have options for job work management, alterations management. You have add-on modules related to those. And you can even have options for offer and schemes, gift vouchers, coupon configurations, membership loyalty cards, along with points redemption. And you can even, as you grow up with your business and as you scale up, you even have option for multi-branch solution where you can have chain of stores and the data will get auto-synchronized to your head office, and with a lot of additional options of branch-wise sales and stock comparison. And for retail outlets specifically, we can even configure different counters for billing, payments and delivery with complete tracking of at each counter barcode wise. You can even maintain separate sessions, separate counter for sales return, and at the end of the day you can maintain user wise cash management as per the payment terminals. So you can have user session and cash management and overall day ending options. So on a large scale outlet also, entire thing can be configured in Max ERP. So this is one single robust solution for all textile boutiques as well as large size outlets for managing the complete business operations for multi branches. And we can even configure SMS and email at different levels for auto alerts for administrators or for approvals and OTPs, along with mobile app. So it's a complete robust solution for textile stores. Do let us know in case of any queries, and thank you for watching this demo. Have a great day. Thank you.